हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अ न्यू चैप्टर, केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. इट इंक्लूड्स केमिकल बॉन्ड्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल बॉन्ड. केमिकल बॉन्ड एंड टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल बॉन्ड. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द चैप्टर केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज केमिकल बॉन्ड. व्हाट इज केमिकल बॉन्ड? इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस मेनी टाइम आई टोल्ड यू ऑल, केमिकल बॉन्ड इज फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इन बिटवीन एटम्स ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल. Okay, so whatever force of attraction exists in between atoms of molecule is called as chemical bond. For example, suppose this is H2 molecule. So whatever force of attraction occurs in between H and H. Okay, whatever force it exists here to hold these two atoms in H2 molecule is called as chemical bond, right? What I told, whatever force exists in between these two atom of hydrogen so that they can survive in H2 molecule is called as chemical bond. It's called as chemical bond. I hope you people understood the definition of chemical bond with this suitable example, right? Now see, why chemical bond is formed? Why there is a need of chemical bonding? Why chemical bond is formed? ? What is reason behind it? Why chemical bond is formed? See, chemical bond is formed by an atom to get stability, to achieve minimum energy level state. In the previous video I told you all these two concept of stability and concept of to achieve minimum energy level state. In previous class I told you all, a system which have low energy is stable, while a system which have high energy is unstable. So a chemical bond is formed so that a molecule can achieve minimum energy level state. Okay, before chemical bonding atoms have high energy. Okay, whenever they comes close to form a chemical bond, their energy continuously radiates. And ultimately, when bond is formed, its energy becomes minimum. And in this way, atoms become stable in the form of molecule. Right? Second reason is, to achieve stability. So, chemical bond is formed to achieve stability. How stability can be achieved? Stability can be achieved by achieving electronic configuration of nearest noble gas, right? How an atom can become stable? An atom can become stable by achieving the electronic configuration of nearest noble gas. It means atom want to become noble gas. Why atom want to become noble gas? Because if you talk about periodic table, in entire periodic table, only noble gases are stable. Noble gases are stable. So let's see the condition of noble gas and other element in the periodic table. Okay, let's see the condition of noble gas and other elements in the periodic table. If we talk about the condition of noble gas in the periodic table, they are stable. Noble gases are stable, while other element except noble gas are unstable. Why? The question is why? Why only noble gases are stable? Why not other elements? There is a reason behind it. Noble gases are stable because they follow duplet and octet. I hope you people know what is duplet and octet. Duplet means to have two electrons in the only one cell present in an atom, which is outermost shell. What I told? Duplet means to have two electrons in the only one cell, which is outermost cell. While octet is to have 8 electrons in the outermost cell of an atom. So if we talk about the condition of noble gas, either they follow duplet rule or octet rule. It means either they have 2 electrons in the outermost shell or 8 electrons in the outermost shell. That's why they are stable. Clear? It means atoms having 8 electrons or 2 electrons in the outermost shell is stable. So throughout the periodic table, only noble gases are the element which have either 2 or 8 electrons in the outermost shell. That's why they are stable. So other elements except noble gases in the periodic table, they want to become noble gas so that they can achieve the stable electronic configuration like noble gas. So let us see the example of noble gas. Noble gas includes helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Radon is a radioactive element. Don't bother about it. Its stability, its property is not readable because they are unstable. The nucleus is unstable. Atomic number 2, atomic number 10, 18 plus 18, 36 plus 18, 54 is the electronic configuration. The atomic number. Electronic configuration, 2 electron, only one cell, which is outermost cell, that's why it's stable. 28, K cell 2, L cell 8, outermost containing 8 electron, that's why it's stable. 2, 8, 8, again outermost cell is containing 8 electron, that's why it's stable. If you talk about krypton, 2, 8, 18, 8, again 8 electron in the outermost shell, that's why krypton is stable. Now come at xenon, 2, 8, 18, 18, 8, again 2 electron, again sorry 8 electron in the outermost shell, that's why xenon is stable. I hope you people understood why noble gases are stable, because they have 8 electron in the outermost shell. So other elements also want to achieve the electronic configuration like noble gases. Okay, so how other elements can achieve electronic configuration like other elements like noble gases? Now question is how other elements can achieve electronic configuration like noble gases? Question mark. How other elements can achieve electronic configuration, EC means electronic configuration, like noble gases? So to achieve electronic configuration like noble gases, other atoms either transfer or share electrons in between atoms, right? How other elements can achieve electronic configuration like noble gas. They can achieve electronic configuration like noble gas either by transfer of electron or share of electron. Okay, they can achieve electronic configuration either by transfer or share of electron in between atoms. And this sharing or transfer of electron is called as valency of that particular atom. Okay, known as valency. What is valency? The number of electrons transferred or shared by an atom so that they can achieve electronic configuration of nearest noble gas is known as valency. In previous videos, I have told you all about valency. Whatever electron is shared by an atom to achieve a stable electronic configuration of nearest noble gas is known as valence electron. I hope you people understood what is valency, what is valence electron, and how an atom can achieve electronic configuration of nearest noble gas. How they can achieve? By sharing or by transferring of electron in between the atoms. Right? So whenever they transfer or shared electron in between, it lead to the formation of chemical bond. Okay? It lead toward the formation of chemical bond. Right? So now we will understand how many types of chemical bond. Types of chemical bond. Okay, if we talk about types of chemical bond as per your syllabus, it includes covalent bond, it is also known as molecular bond. Second is electrovalent bond is also known as ionic bond, right? Briefly, we will also try to understand coordinate bond. Though these two are the part of your syllabus. Covalent bond, electrovalent bond, coordinate bond, briefly we will learn. Right? One by one. So that's all for today's class. In next video, we will discuss how covalent bonds are formed. And after that, next video we will discuss how electrovalent bonds are formed. So that's all. Thank you for today.